Hey everyone, Pupsker here, and it is official finally. We are getting Nidus Prime September 8th on the same day as the Plague Star update. We're getting pretty much everything. Nidus Prime access begins September 8th. So, in that, I will now finally be able to kill my disgusting looking atrocious Nidus color pattern and be able to build out the sick Nidus Prime. So everyone, even though it's been speculated and everyone assumed we would get Nidus Prime September 8th with Gaara Prime access disappearing, it is now official. We're losing to the Prime Vault, I think Atlas Prime, so that's important to note, but we're just losing Gaara Prime access, which is the payable, and we're gaining Nidus Prime access. So if you want to spend a bunch of money buying that, go ahead, but let's take a look at the news post. Yeah, in my last video, I totally messed up since I was just completely out of it and said, like, Gaara Prime was leaving. No. Just Gaara Prime access, okay? We're still keeping Gaara Prime with Atlas Prime going into the vault. So, let's take a look. Infest, outlive, and ultimately overrun your enemies with Nidus Prime access. Beautiful. Add the Infested Prime Warframe Nidus, Prime weapons, exclusive Prime accessories, and more to your arsenal instantly on September 8th, or track down and crack relics in-game to craft Nidus Prime, Strun Prime, and Magnus Prime. So, we're getting Strun Prime, Magnus Prime as the weapons, and Nidus Prime as the Warframe. The mass of flesh and sinew that was once a hurling-fested asteroid is showing signs of renewed life, festering and breathing once more, and as putrid as always. Return to the Plains of Eidolon starting September 8th for Operation Plague Star, and earn relics containing Nidus Prime blueprints. Not to mention you can earn the new Ghoul Saw heavy melee weapon. Make sure to check out the Revenant Mephisto collection in the market too. It's the Revenant skin with the massive penis. So I'm just gonna go out and say it, okay? You'll be able to find parts for the Undying Prime Warframe and his weapons through the usual sources for Void Relics, such as Relic Packs and Void Missions during and after the event has ended. Nidus Prime access. So we're getting a Nidus Prime, Strun Prime, and Magnus Prime. Mutation is endless. The Ravening Plague Bearer returns in a long unseen form. Seething with a primal strain of the infestation, features altered mod polarities for greater customization. Strun Prime, a classic shotgun design embellished for the elite as only the Orokin could, features altered mod polarities for greater customization. And Magnus Prime, Orokin elegance meets formidable stopping power in the exquisite revolver, and features altered mod blah. Exclusive Nidus Prime glyphs. We're getting a Necromech Nidus Prime, I guess, accessories skin, and it looks beautiful. We're getting a Warframe Sindana, also looks beautiful. Infested Orbiter decorations, that'll look great. That's the Necromech skin. We're getting the Krynoth Prime Sindana, that one right there. 90-day resource and affinity booster. And again, when Nidus Prime enters the vault, Atlas Prime, Techo Prime, and Deathcute Prime are entering the vault with Gaara Prime access being unable to purchase. So, thank you all for watching. Make sure to sub and follow and check out some of my other videos. I will definitely be streaming a ton of Nidus Prime farming and Plague Star farming because it is time to farm up Forma when that drops. So until then, it'll be pretty much casual, but we'll wait. So thank you all for watching, and I will see you next time. Peace.